Hon, would you mind just for a couple of minutes?
I'm sorry to barge in like this. You know, it's...
Actually, I do mind. Could you try to conduct your business somewhere away from our front door?
I'm sorry. I truly am. But some things can't be avoided.
Angel, I'll take care of this fast.
Okay. I'll go upstairs and melt my eyes.
Frank called.
Yeah, well, it's Valentine's Day. I guess my card from him must have got lost in the mail.
No, actually, he's not in too good of mood. It seems that the esteemed Dr. Gary went to see Donnelly.
Why?
That's what Frank wants to know.
Well, you saw him. This Dr. Gary's a mass of neurotic tics.
Yeah, that might be, but it also could be that somebody turned him around. Somebody that spent a great deal of time with him.
And who would that be, Sonny?
You?
Is that what you told Frank? That I turned that nutcase against him?
No, at the moment, it's just a theory. But I'm all ears. Explain to me the sudden turn of events.
Sonny, you're standing in my house. In my living room, making some pretty wild accusations. That's not the way we do business.
I'm just trying to save your butt.
Let me try to bite down on this. You say Dr. Gary went to the police commissioner and blew the whistle on Frank's plan.
That's what it looks like. The paranoia kid suddenly disappeared, presumably into protective custody.
And you think I sent him to...
It doesn't matter what I think. It's what Frank thinks that counts.
No, it's what you said to Frank, what you told him that counts.
You were the last one to see Gary before he cracked up.
How do you know?
Frank had people watching his hotel room. You were seen going in the next morning. He shows up at Donnelly's office, flipping out.
Oh, come on, man. You know as well as I do he has a thatched roof. When we pulled him out of the Long Island Sound, he was blubbering like a piece of fish. Anything could have set him off. Hotel food, those little mints they put on the pillows, a ringing telephone.
A large dog.
Sonny, I like you. I'll tell you everything that went down between me and Dr. Gary. But you've got to come clean with me about what Frank's plan is.
I told you, I don't know.
The hell you don't. Everything we've done points to a breakout. You know it and I know it. Stop tap dancing. There's nobody to trust here but each other. Stop the games.
All right. There's a breakup. Are you satisfied?
I think it's important that we tell each other the truth about what we know.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Let's hear it. What the hell were you doing in Gary's hotel room?
Well, I wasn't trying to talk him out of the job. If anything, I was trying to talk him down off the ceiling. You saw how squirrely that guy was. I thought he was losing his mind as well as his nerve.
So you gave him a pep talk.
I also bought him drugs. He was bouncing off the walls when I got there. He wrote himself a little prescription. I went out and got a fill for him.
Mm-hmm. And?
And then we talked, which wasn't easy given his state of mind. You know, I have to worry about Frank's sanity. Would you put your face under that guy's knife? I mean, he may be a doctor, but he belongs in a rubber room.
He has a very impressive track record. He's done jobs for Frank before. There's no reason to believe he couldn't handle this one.
I can't help but wonder if there aren't some faces out there twitching that he's sliced and folded.
What you should be wondering is how you're going to convince Frank you didn't turn Gary.
I convinced you, didn't I?
Yeah, you convinced me.
Sonny, come on. If I had an ulterior motive, why would I just waltz into the hotel in open view like that? That would be stupid.
Yeah, it would.
And also, I'm so close to having this deal finally finished with Frank. I wouldn't jeopardize it by trusting any fruitcake like that. I'm too close to having this over.
You should know Frank wasn't thrilled at all the questions you've been asking.
I don't give a hell what thrills Frank. You know me. I can't fly blind. I have to see the whole picture.
Still, if Frank blames you for his breakup plan going south, you're a dead man.
Then you'll convince him he's wrong.
Oh, no, no, no. I'm not doing that. No. No.
But I'll convince him he's wrong.
How?
I'll break him out myself.
You'll break him out.
Yeah, I'll need a little help.
Time out a second. Frank had a little army lined up to bust him. You're going to tell me two guys can do it?
The right two guys with the right plan. Sure, it'd be clean and we move fast. Fewer moving parts, the machinery would run smoother, all of that. And besides, this way you can keep an eye on me, which will make your boss very happy.
Show me a plan that'll work. I'm in. Right. But you got to get straight with Frank.
Okay, set me up a meeting.
I'll be in touch.
And use the phone.
Got it.